What are we talking about today on my show?
Today on your show, we're going to be talking about my opinion of the state of the DCEU post-Suicide Squad and what the fuck Warner Brothers is going to do.
Uh-oh, this one's going to be racy.
It's going to be a live one.
You're going to be drinking heavily.
It's a wake for the DCEU.
Oh my gosh, you can't say that. Too soon.
Just start over.
Too soon.
Opinion of Suicide Squad. Well, you know, the premise, I like the premise. I like that you have this rogues gallery of villains and they all have to come together and they work for the government, they're forced to work for the government, and like you get to see things from their perspective. I think that's really interesting. I like villainry. So there's a lot of potential in that idea, but the DCEU has not really impressed me thus far. I'm not a fan of Man of Steel. I did not like BVS. So I didn't have a lot of faith going into this, okay? But I saw that trailer with the Queen song in it. And I mean, that was a great trailer. That was a really good trailer. But the thing is, I know that trailers are not indicative of what the actual movie is going to be like. So I was like, well, if this is as fun and awesome as this trailer is, well, then maybe it could be good. And I saw the movie, and it's safe to say Suicide Squad was a mess. And it earned that 26% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Ooh.
Because you have one film that's like Man of Steel. Okay, that was a misstep. Then you have BVS, and it's like, oh gosh, another misstep. And you think Suicide Squad, okay, third time's a charm, right? Like, maybe you guys got it figured out. So like, and this is something that I've been seeing this building, and I'm like, what is Warner Brothers gonna do? Like, what are they gonna do? Like, they fucked it up from the fucking get-go. I'm sad for them, like, and it's hard for me to watch, and I'm just like, it's fascinating. I mean, it's just a train wreck. And it's, instead of just being one movie that's a train wreck, because you know a lot of, like, I like train wreck movies and like hearing about what happens in a train wreck movie. But this is like a train wreck franchise, okay?
Well, you sure you're not being too mean?
No.
They turn it all around.
I think that the only way to unsink this ship is to sink it and build a whole new ship and just pretend like the other ship didn't happen.
Titanic 2. Directed by James Cameron.
Oh my God. I used to run track. I was a sprinter, right? And the thing is like, you know, when you come out of those blocks, if you come out of the blocks all fucked up and you come out wrong, then like your chances of winning that race are like severely fucking like your chances, it just goes down, okay? And they've come out of the blocks all wrong. Like they stumbled and fell and like did a somersault and like hit their nose and they're bleeding everywhere. And now they're trying to get up and sprint towards the finish line. I've been saying that this shit's a fucking mess for years, ever since Man of Steel. I was like, this is not good. Like, this is not gonna work. Like, this is not what you base your entire foundation of your entire franchise on.
Do you feel like no one's been listening to you?
No. I feel like Mugatu in Zoolander.
Doesn't anyone notice this? I feel like I'm taking crazy pills.
It's like, it's the same face. Like, how do people not say this? Like, it's just, it's killing me inside. It's just, ugh. And I want them to figure it out and I want them to do a good job, but it's like, they're not going to do it the way they've been doing things. And that's, and they're so on this fucking course and they've locked themselves into this fucking course that they can't get out of. How are they gonna fucking fix this? All right? I don't know. Well, I mean, it isn't. It's not even funny to make fun of them because it's just sad. Like, I don't even wanna make fun of them. Like, I don't even wanna make jokes about it. I just want it to be over. Like.
You feel bad for them?
I do feel bad for them. I mean, I.
Well, then what should they do?
Well, I partly feel bad for them, but I partly, you know, I'm just like, what did you guys think was gonna happen? You know, like. Does anyone care? Like, I don't know. I mean, should everyone be fired over there? Should the whole studio collapse? I don't know, you know? Here's the thing, like, Warner Brothers hasn't lost any money yet, you know, yet. But the thing is like, they can't keep going like this. Like, this isn't going to suffice. They cannot continue to do this. And so, quit while you're ahead. You know, quit while you're ahead. You made some gambles, some risky fucking gambles, and, you know, you made your money back, and just stop now. It's just really disturbing. It's just disturbing to watch so much short-sightedness and people who don't, they just don't care, you know, and they have all this money and they have all this power and this is what they do with it. This is what they do with it. I mean, I absolutely do think there are people out there who could fix this, who would know what to do with the DCEU continuity universe, like who could fucking fix this and make this work. Like, yeah, I'm sure there are ways to make this work, but, you know, they're not being hired. I don't even have the, God, I don't even have the fire for this. I just don't care. It's just out of me. Should I get a new job? I feel like I should get a new job. I'm having an existential crisis while filming this. Like, I just can't. I can't anymore with these movies. Like, it's just killing me. It's killing me to try to explain them, why they're bad. It kills me that people think that they're great. I don't know what to do. Like, I don't know what to do. It's the same arguments, round and round we go, you know? Like, you guys just don't fucking give a shit about storytelling, you know? Just make it look cool, you know?
But your name is Comic Book Girl 19. You're Comic Book Girl 19. You're supposed to like everything that's comic books.
Am I? This is this existential crisis. I'm telling you. Oh, this review is just giving me a hard time today. I don't know what to do, guys. I don't know what to tell everybody.
I think we should all just make that robot movie that I've been writing.
Fuck, man. I'm down. Best thing to come out of Suicide Squad, top story, is this picture of Jared Leto. He is at a fashion show, some swanky fashion show, and there's this guy and he's walking. Support for the Comic Book Girl 19 show comes from Patreon, and special thanks to our super patrons, Michael Wurlitz, A7XBum, Kyle Slicer, Andrew Moncada, and Daniel Hughmeyer. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for your support. You guys are fucking killing it out there.